everyone to episode 4 of Reviews with Ranjani. So the book that we're going to be reviewing today is around one of the hottest topics, hottest trending topics, and it also happens to be a personal area of interest. It's around AI, superintelligence, and the future of humanity. So the book that I'm talking about is called Life 3.0. It's by Max Tegmark, and it talks about what it means to be human in the age of artificial intelligence. So the author is a professor of physics at MIT, and he also is the president of the Future of Life Institute. All right, so back to the book, right? Why do you think we as humans are as curious? Why do you think we explore or peep into the future? It reminds me of this quote I read somewhere, that the myth of human existence lies not just in staying alive, but in finding something to live for. So with that, I'll focus today on one of the most controversial topics around AI, which the book highlights: goals. Should we be giving AI goals? And if so, what goals? Who should be giving these goals? How do we ensure that these goals do not change over time and are retained even when the AI becomes smarter? Can we change the goals of AI when it becomes smarter than us? So there are a lot of these questions, and while we ponder about these questions, there are four different areas that the author talks about in detail that I want to cover, maybe through two parts. So the first is, what is the origin of goals as in general and sub-goals? How do we make AI learn these goals? How do we make AI adopt these goals? And finally, how do we make AI retain these goals? So we'll talk about the first and the second point today. So point number one, what do you think is the ultimate origin of goals and sub-goals? And taking a step back, you'd realize that the origins of this goal-oriented behavior involves optimization, which means that out of all the ways in which nature can do something, it always chooses or prefers the most optimal way of doing it. That is, either minimizing or maximizing a particular quantity. For example, nature strives to maximize entropy, or the degree of messiness in the environment at all times. Think of a movie, right, where say someone is drinking a glass of wine and he drops it. You expect it to fall down and shatter. You do not expect it to unshatter and come back. That's going to be unbelievable, right? So that's the way entropy works. There's always an increase in the degree of messiness in the environment. And the way, one of the ways in which nature achieves this is through life itself. So we grow in complexity and replicate to increase the messiness in the environment. So evolution at some point in time shifted its goal-oriented behavior from dissipation of messiness to replication. So did the goal change? No. We created a sub-goal of replication to a larger goal of dissipation. And understanding this goal-sub-goal framework is important when we try to create AI to learn these goals. So let's get back to talking about AI goals. Super intelligent AI will be extremely good at accomplishing its goals. And if the goal of the AI system is not aligned to us, then we are in a lot of trouble. So we as humans do not... there's a very interesting analogy which he calls out. Something which I've read from Elon Musk as well. Think about this scenario. We do not really consider worry much about flooding an anthill at times, right? So do we really want to put humanity in the position of ants? So the author draws this analogy to talk about why it's important to think about aligning the goals of the AI with ours, which is something which he calls friendly AI. So how do we make AI learn our goals? One of the most important things for this is the AI must figure out not just what we do, but why we do it. For example, if I were to tell a self-driving car to take me to the airport as fast as possible, it's going to take that statement literally. And like the author says, you may end up covered in your own vomit by the time you get there. So the AI researchers are trying hard to enable machines to infer goals based on behavior. And this is something through what they call inverse reinforcement learning. And for example, right, think of a robot which is taking care of the elderly. Can it figure out what he values, what the human values, by observing and without necessarily being programmed for it? And the idea behind this inverse reinforcement learning is not just to maximize goal satisfaction, but that of the human owner. So, which implies that the system always has this incentive to be cautious when it's unclear about the owner's likes, and it's gonna do its best to find that out. So, I have a five-year-old, and I understand how difficult it is at times to persuade someone to adopt a goal. And the challenge in persuading a computer is what he calls a value loading problem. So imagine an AI system which has intelligence, which gradually improves from subhuman to superhuman over time through multiple iterations. At first, it's less powerful and it cannot prevent you from shutting it down or replacing its goals. But it may do so once it does become smarter than you, right? So in summary, the time window which we have between when we can load our goals into the AI system is very short. And it's this brief period between when it is too dumb and too smart to allow you to do so. And this period, right, for a five-year-old, for example, for her to reach my level of intelligence may probably take another decade, hopefully. But with the system, it's much, much, much faster. And the author, and that is something which we need to be cognizant about, right? He also calls out some other researchers who are working on what he calls incorrigibility, which is the hope that one can give a primitive AI a goal system that it doesn't really care when it is occasionally shut down. So with that, I'll probably end with this part one of the review. I know that this is a lot of difficult questions, right? And questions which we may not have answers to. But if we do not work on identifying what we want, we may, as the author points out rightly so, end up with where we do not want to be. I really hope you enjoyed this. And I'm gonna take 30 seconds to talk about something else. Why am I doing this? My mother recently called me to, or rather scolded me about how I'm trying to stretch myself thin by doing this along with a day job and a home to manage and a five-year-old. I lost my dad earlier this year. He was my superhero, and one of the last things that I promised dad is that I would make him proud. So this is for you, Appa. Thank you, guys.